Hey, thank you so much for that intro, Nazgul. It's great to be here, partnering with DrChrono and speaking with you all today. But before we get started, just quickly, want to share a little bit more on myself. I'm Chase Johnson. I'm an account executive here at Ambra. I've been at Ambra for the past 3 years, and I'm currently located in New York City, where we're headquartered. And then we also have a large office out in Denver. For Ambra, I'm currently covering the mountain region, which is Montana and Idaho, stretching down through the Rockies into the Four Corners. And then we also include Texas within that. So a rather large area. For those of you that aren't familiar with Ambra, I thought it'd be helpful to give a high-level overview before diving in a little bit more into our integration with DrChrono. Ambra Health is a medical data and image management SaaS company. So essentially what this means is we take medical imaging, like x-rays, CTs, ultrasounds, and move and store them in the cloud. In total, Ambra has 411 customers, probably a little bit more as of right now as we continue to grow, and those figures are a couple weeks old. And those customers have connected to about 3,000 facilities directly sharing images bi-directional. Within the next couple of months, we'll also surpass 7 billion images under management within Ambra. The Ambra Cloud is designed to serve as the backbone for imaging innovation and progress for healthcare providers. Being a cloud system, we want to do things like integrate with the EHR and drive streamlined workflows as much as possible. We work with organizations including hospitals and health systems, radiology groups, imaging centers, research organizations, and really our largest segment is outpatient private practices. So with DrChrono, Ambra has partnered to really streamline everything through the EHR. So it's pretty easy to image enable DrChrono and allow physicians and staff to access imaging directly through the patient record without needing to log into a separate system. Ambra has simple specifications for custom links that we can send to DrChrono, and then that enables the EMR to take those links, embed them within the patient record, and create a list of all the patient's imaging that can be directly accessed alongside other EMR tools. What this amounts to is a single location for accessing all your imaging data related to a specific patient, as well as any associated radiology reports for that patient. Additionally, on the patient portal side, we can enhance the patient experience by integrating with DrChrono's patient portal, allowing them to upload images as well as access their images from the existing portal. So we have those options to both streamline your practice internally and then also the relationship with the patients, both coming in and leaving your facility. So a quick level of how this works. Essentially, when you log into DrChrono, you'll see on the side where all your tabs are, there will be an Ambra tab as you scroll down to the bottom. And this creates that unique link when you click on that tab. That unique link has been generated, and you can see all the associated images for that specific patient and any radiology reports associated with those images. So this is a really streamlined way of accessing all the information directly through one link, and then you'll have the ability to toggle back and forth as you open images and go into other areas of the patient record. And it's a really nice streamlined way of making sure everything is in one spot. So this is a quick mock-up of what it looks like. One thing I'd like to point out, and you'll see this difference when I demo it later on, is as you click into the work list and you pull up in the viewer actually opens in a separate tab. Now this is advantageous since instead of toggling back and forth between tabs, if you want to open a separate tab, within DrChrono, you won't be pulled away from the image and you can still access that image without it being closed out. The same is true for radiology reports. Those will open in a separate tab. I'm happy to discuss any questions around that as well. So a little bit more background on Ambra and some of the organizations that we work with today. So as you can see, these are larger organizations, kind of notable across the country, a couple of health systems, some radiology groups, as well as research organizations. However, with as I mentioned, with the bulk of our client base, it really is outpatient practices using us in a variety of different ways as a flexible solution, doing things like integrating with the EHR, storage, and cloud packs. We've also been named the class category leader for image exchange for the last 5 years since the category was introduced. And essentially what image exchange amounts to is going to be the access of imaging for your providers. So receiving images inbound, reducing hassles of CDs, getting images from outside facilities or on an ad hoc basis through uploads. It also pertains to sharing downstream to patients, outside providers, or even outside facilities if they have a separate PAC system. So Ambra can function in many different ways and has many different features. And the flexibility is really indicative of the range of organizations that we work with. However, today I want to focus on Cloud PACS, which is used by many private practices as a scalable solution and low maintenance solution for managing their medical imaging. So a lot of our outpatient organizations, they use us as a Cloud PACS system. A lot of the higher organizations, larger organizations may use us in separate use cases. Cloud PACS shares many similarities with a traditional PACS system. The main difference is that rather than being hardware located and managed on site by your team at the facility, everything will be hosted off-site in a centrally managed data center. This is where our head engineering team sits, manages that data, and sits alongside, make sure all the servers are working and doing that troubleshooting. A cloud-based PACS system then reduces the cost typically associated with on-site hardware, as well as ensures continuity by including things like second copy, disaster recovery within the licensing of the product. The flexibility of cloud architecture also makes it easy to bridge the gap, which is really what we're seeing more and more times with the state of the industry. So as these new laws are applied, especially with CMS, ONC, more digital access is being required to reduce things like duplicate imaging and giving patients online access to images. One of the best ways that we've seen this this happen is through integrating through traditional mediums, patient portals, as well as the EHR, to make sure that providers on the other end have access to the images that they need at the point of care or ahead of time. This calls for a reduction in duplicate imaging, simply since you'll have the access ahead of time, you can ensure that the images are viewable before a patient comes in. Additionally, patients that are leaving facilities are demanding more access to their imaging. And this is really where a patient portal, image enabling a patient portal comes in, instead of burning out a CD, that might have a specialized viewer, be password protected, they could lose before their next appointment. Having a digital record not only gives them power, but also streamlines your workflow on the back end. So instead of having your administrative staff burn that CD, you can just share out to them and they can have that digital record, or they can log into a patient portal and have that digital record. Interoperability is really the biggest driver of solving these issues. So few image-enabled, few EHR systems are kind of working towards this. So we partnered with EHRs, especially ones that are cloud-based, complementing what we do at Ambra being a cloud-based system to really drive the workflows and the access to data through the EHR and through patient portals. Ultimately, one thing that we really are focused on is reducing CDs and on-site media that are distracting from patient care or can cause time wasted in the point of care or throughout the care process. So oftentimes it could be lost CDs, it could be scratched CDs, and we want to eliminate that as much as possible. So kind of what I just discussed on the last slide, but here's a similar workflow and what we see oftentimes and what is trying to be solved. So a patient will come in to a hospital or they'll see a GP, they'll get imaging done at the hospital or they'll get imaging done at a specialist facility. From there, they'll receive a CD. At their next appointment, they're expected to either bring that CD to the specialist or send it to them ahead of time. And oftentimes we see a failed CD upload at the point of care. This could either be scratches or lost CD, password protecting, et cetera. And either then they must have the new CD burned for them at the original facility, which causes time and rescheduling, or duplicate imaging, which is unnecessary exposure for that patient. So we want to reduce the amount of time and the burdens on the patient by streamlining that process, either through having patients the ability to upload a CD ahead of coming in, requesting images from outside facilities, or syncing up with a direct transfer method where from outside facilities you can push images directly into your PACS. This is advantageous for the patient and the time wasted at their point of care would be reduced. On the flip side, you'll have a reduction in overall costs. You won't be missing surgery sites or consultations or delayed care, and then increased costs associated with those and administrative factors with having to get the access to the right images. So one of our big initiatives right now is to ditch the disc. As I just mentioned, improving patient care to kind of cross the spectrum, but really alleviating some of the burden that they have with managing medical imaging, taking that out of their hands and putting it into the hands of the professionals on the back end, but then solving those everyday challenges that administrative staffs are faced with, that physicians and private practices are faced with, of missing surgeries, missing consultations due to unavailable imaging or unreadable discs. Additionally, eliminating the fact for local media like a CD, a flash drive, allows images to be viewed from anywhere within the cloud. So you can log into your EHR, you can log into DrChrono from a laptop, whatever device you use, and have access to your imaging. And Ambra is cloud-based as well, so our viewer can be accessed from anywhere. Additionally, sharing downstream, you'll have simplified sharing directly to email addresses in a HIPAA-compliant manner and collaboration tools if you ever need to work together with outside providers reviewing images in real time. Finally, cutting costs. And a lot of these are soft costs associated with missed appointments, time management spent for your staff, having to burn CDs or manage the ones coming in, or toggling between two different systems for your providers, for doing things like forgetting passwords, et cetera. So we want to eliminate those costs, the soft costs as much as possible, as well as the hard costs of burning CDs and paying for those physical media. So from a high level, we just went over for a lot of the everyday challenges that were trying to be solved. But without integrating imaging into the patient record, EHR users are required to open that new browser and log into a separate system and search for a patient's image exam, which depending upon the system could be cumbersome for that provider. By consolidating everything within the EMR, especially a cloud-based EMR like DrChrono, it simplifies this. They can log on from anywhere and access that imaging. In addition, you can easily share directly from modalities or from the web itself to outside facilities. So if you're at the point of care, you've taken that image, instead of burning that CD, you can share outbound. And really, everything that we're trying to solve, there's the physical media and the patient care is really important, but ultimately it boils down to wasted time for the patient getting the care that they need, or juggling CDs and having to deal with that. And then wasted time on your end. You want to see as many patients as possible. You want to perform as many surgeries, have as many consultations, and having to juggle physical media, deal with on-premise hardware, not having the access you need, is all wasted time ultimately for your practice. So as you'll see in a couple minutes, the ability to view from anywhere at any time. Right now I'm on my laptop, but you can log in on a desktop or even iPad, iPhone, and be able to view your images directly from Ambra's web-based browser. It's a diagnostic quality browser as well and doesn't require any downloads or anything to access, which is great when you're talking about collaboration with outside physicians. You can send links out to them and collaborate in real time since they don't need to download anything. This is a really lean and fast way to get secondary input on any images that you'd want to be looking at. Additionally, we have a whole host of tools, so moving, annotating, scrolling, zooming, window leveling, and I'll show some of these within the demo in just a few minutes here, but these are all tracked in real time throughout the process, so that you can see what other attendees are doing live during any collaboration. Finally, sharing downstream with outside providers is really easy. I'll show quickly the fastest way to do it directly from the EHR. And then there are always other ways to do as well, from site to site transfers, ad hoc sharing, temporary sharing links that we can show as well, more on the back end. Maybe administrators, front desk staff, or techs would be doing this if they want to log directly into Ambra. But there's a lot of different tools for sharing outbound and ultimately reducing the hassles of CDs needed to be bought and then burned and handled at the practice. So right now, I'm going to dive into the demonstration. If you have any questions, please shoot them into the note, but happy to answer those at the end. Want to make sure that everything is covered that people are interested in learning more about. One second, I'm just going to pull up my screen. So as you can see, I'm logged into DrChrono on the web here. I'll make this full screen. So just as you're doing today, you can log into DrChrono directly over the web. And I'm not an expert in this, you guys know it best, but going straight into the patient list, you can see where the patients that you need to be accessing are. So right now, if I'm going to consult with Jenny Harris later on today, I can open up her chart. You can see all the new demographics up here, any notifications. And if I scroll down here on the side, you'll see the Ambra Studies list. So this is that unique link that's been passed through to DrChrono, and then they can then generate a list of all available studies for that patient. So So if I'm scrolling through, you'll see a couple of different things. You'll see the patient's name, what the description of the study is, what type of study, the referring physician, et cetera. So we can display any DICOM tags that would be needed and helpful for viewing the images. Images can be viewed using this eye icon, and I'll just choose to open this image right here. And as you can see, it launches in a separate viewer. This is nice because then you can then toggle back to the EHR if you'd like to see anything else. So within the viewer, I can then do a couple of different things. The first being, if the layout wants to be changed by the physician's preference, we can do things like boxes, side-by-side comparisons for two separate angles or different images. We also have window leveling available, annotations, including line, text annotations, areas of interest, angles, et cetera. Images can be export. If you're doing any cardio or anything that requires Cine, you can actually play a Cine as well. And you have the ability to zoom in and out. As you can see, this is rendered to diagnostic quality as well, for just enhanced viewing experience. I'd like to point out down here, you can see several studies. You can see the names of those studies, and the clock down here indicates that it's a prior study. So this is really nice. You can see any associated prior studies for that patient directly within the viewer and actually load those for side-by-side comparisons. So I can pull up that prior and have that be side-by-side. Stepping out of the viewer, and happy to answer any questions on that at the end as well. But stepping out of the viewer, you can go back to the study worklist, and any associated reports that for the images will actually reside right alongside. So you can then open that report as well and continue to toggle back and forth. Finally, directly from the worklist, you're actually able to check an image as well. So if you wanted to share an image outbound, you could do so, message to the recipient. And you'll have the option of sharing directly to an email address. And this is really nice. You can see the emails right up there if you want to share directly to the patient themselves. It's really easy to copy and paste. There's no PHI attached in any email. It just says that they're invited to come view the imaging and it was shared with them. They would have to log in or register with Ambra if there's no patient portal integration where they can log in and register and access through DrChrono. But on the ad hoc basis, they can access the imaging directly over the web after registering and have any of the images that you shared out with them in a digital format. You can also do the same method to share out to an outside provider on an ad hoc basis as well, if you need to share downstream to anyone. So really quickly, I've shown a couple of different things from within DrChrono, and this is a really great integration, especially for providers. It doesn't have a lot of frills. It really has the images and the reports needed to take care of the patients. However, if anyone did come in on the back end and wanted to have a little bit more functionality, we do have the option of logging into Ambra directly. Once again, this is web-based, and this might be nice for specific people at the practice, perhaps those that are uploading imaging into Ambra. It would be nice for them to have access on the back end, just to have that, or maybe any administrator at the practice IT that wants to have a little bit more control over the back end and track. So really quickly, what I want to show is adding a study into Ambra. into the work list, and then downstream this would integrate into DrChrono. So it's really easy to do this directly from the patient, from the work list itself. So I'll go to this upload studies page, which is a static link. And you can see, you can even send this out to outside facilities or patients ahead of time if they want to upload the imaging. You want to have access to that ahead of time. As you can see too, support's always available to any end user. So even if you're operating out of DrChrono, you can call or email our support. It's 24/7 domestic-based support. And our direct team will be answering the lines anytime from 9 a.m. to 7 p.m. Eastern Standard Time during the weekdays, and are always available. Someone's always on call as well during the weekends. If not, we do have support and escalation process if anything's happening over the weekend or outside of those times to reach our support team. If I choose a file now, I don't have a CD on my computer, but I do have a folder of DICOM studies right here. So I'll choose to upload a CD. Right now, I'll choose David Lee and upload this local file. Once again, if you had a CD, you'd be able to scan for that. You'd also be able to choose from a files drive if it wasn't on a local file. So you'll see a study description before you upload into Ambra. And then if you want, you could have an example custom field. So if you want additional information to be added to an image before uploading, you can always set these or get rid of these. It's completely up to you. Right now I have them turned on just as a quick example. I'll choose to upload these studies. And this will go directly into the work list when the study is uploading. So first thing that will happen will be you'll get a congratulations message for the uploader themselves, indicating that the study has been uploaded. And then if you go back into the study list, you'll see the actual study at the top. The only case when you wouldn't would be if this study has been uploaded before, and you'll see it would be a duplicate. As you can see, David Lee has been uploaded beforehand. So it indicates that it's a duplicate study. And doesn't create two studies. It matches that to the existing study. There's a more administrative functionality, which I'd be happy to show kind of on an individual basis, but really wanted to show kind of first off the web-based access, how to get images in to Ambra via a CD. You can also do direct transfers through a lightweight piece of Windows software we call our gateway, which can connect to modalities or outside PAC systems. So those are the methods of getting images in. And then within DrChrono itself, I've shown the viewer and the reports, as well as sharing outbound. So I'm going to pause my screen for just a second here while I move back over to the PowerPoint. So really quickly, I just want to go through a use case that you can see. So this Sports and Spine is located out in California. They're a rather large specialty group dealing with a lot of USA Olympic athletes and patients from around the world. One of their big issues with having on-premise hardware, as well as CDs being mailed to them, or having to burn them out if imaging was done on-site. So they switched from Ambra from a local system and CDs to Ambra for a cloud-based experience where they could take some pressure off their IT, reducing having less resources devoted to image management, and then also physician time spent streamlining the access to images so they're not burdened or held captive by CDs being sent inbound. They have everything accessed over the web, which can be digitally uploaded and transferred. Happy to answer any questions on DISC or other customers if that's a question at the end. Really quickly, we will be at the SIM conference next week out in Denver, Colorado. Anyone will be attending. And then back out in Denver the following month in July for AHRA. If anyone would be at either conference, we'd love to have them come stop by the booth, chat with us. We're also always happy to connect offline and make sure that all your questions on Ambra would be answered. Great. Well, I want to thank everyone for helping out today and joining the webinar. Happy to answer any questions right now and continue discussions offline if there's any specific things about Ambra that we don't get to today. Thank you so much, everyone.
So there seems to be one question from one of our attendees. They're asking if we have a template report and if we need the images to automatically load into the report, how would they do that, or is that not possible?
Yeah, so with template reporting, can we expand upon that a little bit? Would the images be loading into the report, or are they looking for a report template alongside the images? To whomever asked that.
Yes, Yvette, actually, if you'd like to ask your question, I've unmuted you if you'd like to expand upon the question. And for everyone else, if you guys do have questions, please put it into the Q&A box and we will be going over it.
Okay. So I'm seeing a couple of different questions, and whoever had the report question, happy to connect with that offline. I think I just need a little bit more information on what you're picturing there.
Yeah, so it seems like they need a summary PDF of the DICOM photos.
So you can export that into a report template within Ambra. One thing is if you're reporting outside of that, into a specific templating service. That's something where it gets a little bit tricky, but you can always export the images as a PDF or download them as well. So there's a couple of different options there for exporting as a PDF. In terms of getting that into a report, I'd like to just learn a little bit more about what the setup looks like today that you're currently using for that reporting before we kind of discuss. It sounds like kind of a niche use case for you all. If you need a key image or the entire DICOM, but would love to talk about that a little bit more offline as well. So one question. I just saw your answer, and we will we'll share along some information as well at the end here. You can have my email address to all attendees in case you want to reach out. So one thing I'm seeing for is cost of Ambra service. Once again, there's two main components to Ambra. So one would be initial setup cost. And this is just based upon the scope of work for training everyone, going through everything. One thing that's great with DrChrono is they're another partner of ours. So we work with them, especially when we're talking about the integration services. That's something that we've done with other practices in the past, and is something easy for us to set up. So there's one component, which is the one-time setup. And then from there, it's going to be ongoing costs based on licensing. And the licensing really includes all the features of Ambra. So 24/7 support, product upgrades, maintenance, that second copy included. You can share, view, edit studies as many times as you'd want. And really is an all-encompassing license based on that. So it really kind of differs from practice to practice. But Monica, I'd be happy to connect offline as well to discuss exactly what your practice would look like in terms of pricing. Can I upload a CD from a radiologist into Ambra? Absolutely. So if you have a CD that has been brought in to the practice by a physician, or a patient, excuse me, or has been sent in by an outside physician or practice into your practice, you can upload that imaging in the way that I showed. So that web uploader tool, if you have a CD drive at the practice, you can log into Ambra via the web and pop that CD into your CD drive and upload the imaging via the web into Ambra to then be viewed alongside any associated reports, if there are reports on those CDs to be viewed as well. Are there any other questions that want to be asked in the Q&A section? One thing I saw in the chat was about the support. So really quickly, Ambra does offer that 24/7 domestic-based support between 9 a.m. and 7 p.m. Eastern. It is our team directly. During those off hours, we have people answering phones and emails to help with troubleshooting. If it needs to be up, scaled up to a team member, we always have someone on call as well that works directly for Ambra support team and can help to answer those questions. Once again, that's included within the licensing, so no extra cost for the support there. Are there any other questions that people would want to submit into the Q&A section? Well, great. I really appreciate everyone's time today. If there's additional questions that I couldn't get to today, I think we'll be sending out a follow-up as well, and we can include my contact information on that follow-up to ensure that you get connected with myself or one of my colleagues to help answer that question that you'd have on Ambra. We'll pass along both the phone number and the email to help with that.